the previous class we have discussed topic importing modules in a Python program. Today continuously we have to do same topic again with another example. In previous class we have discussed this topic with the help of built-in function. Now same topic continuously we have to do with the help of user defined function. In previous class we have discussed these three methods. One is importing entire module, second is importing selected objects from a module, third import all objects of a module. So one by one we have to discuss with the user defined function. Let's take an example. Suppose I want to make a calculator project. In a calculator project there are four modules. One is addition, second one is subtraction, third one is division, and fourth one is multiplication. So basic four things we need for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Here you know very well, or in the previous class we have discussed about this, each module has a separate name, means each module has .py extension. So here we have to create a main file, its name is demo.py, demo.py. py denotes this file is a Python file and its name is demo. Now here in this program I want to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, division with two variables. So I have taken here two variables, a equals to 9 and b equals to 7. So 9 is the initial value of a and 7 is the initial value of b. After that I want to perform here all the things. When we write all the things here for addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, so it makes a complex program. So for this we have to make module. So we have to create separate modules. So create separate module in separate files. So see here I am creating one another file, its name is calc.py. Spelling of calc is calc.py. Py denotes this is a Python file. Write all the functions here just like this. This is the definition of addition. Def denotes this is the definition of addition. A comma b, these two are the arguments of this function. Then return a plus b means all the operations are performed here and this value is returned to the calling function. Similarly some more function you have to write here, like subserve a comma b. This function is for subtraction a minus b. Similarly def multi is for multiplication. Again it requires two variables. Then write return a multiply b. Similarly def div a comma b colon. Colon represent this is a compound statement, means this requires statements. Then return a divide by b, like this. All the functions definition you have to write in module calc.py. Now after that suppose I want to add here, I want to import this module add in my module calc in my main program. So we have to write this import import calc. If I am writing import calc, that means it represents first one importing method, importing entire module. So means when we write import calc, then it represent it covers all the function which comes under calc.py module. Means it include add function as well as sub, byte or div function. Clear? Then how we call this function? We have to call this function by writing like this: calc.add and pass these two variables here. Clear? And return is present, so you have to take one variable like c. This is the calling part. Calling function goes to the called function here and perform all the addition operation, and then return means it will return the value and store in variable c, and then by using print statement you have to print the value of c, then you will get the result. Is it clear? This is the way to import entire module. If you want to access, similarly you want to access sub function, same thing you have to write here. You have to take one more variable, d equals to calc dot sub bracket, pass the arguments like a comma b. Clear? Now this is a example based on second one topic, importing selected objects from a module. Selected objects in this module, calc.py module, having four functions: add, sub, multi and div function. But here in the main program, means in demo.py, this main file, I want to access only two functions from the module calc.py. One is add and second one is sub. So we will write line like this: from, then module name. So calc is a module name. Import which function, which object we want to import. Here we want to import add as well as sub. So either you have to write separate lines for importing, or second method is, in place of these two lines, you write like this: from calc import add comma sub. Both are correct. Either you have to write separate lines for this, or you have to write in a same line: add comma sub. So from calc import add comma sub, or from calc import add, from calc import add sub. Then take the value a equals to 9, b equals to 7. These are the initial values. Then c equals to add a comma b, and d equals to sub a comma b. When you are taking selected objects from the module, then that time no need to write module name at the time of calling. So no need to write here calc.add, calc.subtract. That in the previous example we have discussed about this calc.add, but here in this method, importing selected object from a module, there is no need to write calc. Means module dot module name not necessary while you calling your function. Then this calling part goes to the called function and perform here, and answer will return and store in this variable, and after that we can print with the help of print statement. Is it clear? Now this is the third example based on third way: import all objects of a module. So access all objects from module, you have to use this asterisk symbol. So here module name is calc. Calc is a module name, and asterisk sign denotes all the objects which comes under calc module. So we can access these functions or objects by using this method: from calc import asterisk. See here, a equals to 9, b equals to 7, then c equals to multi a comma b. Same here, in this example I want to call multi function. So multi, this is the calling part, calling pass goes to the called function in the module calc. So here the value of a assigned 9, value of b assigned here 7, and then performing calculation 63 return and store in this variable c and display the result with the help of print statement. Is it clear? So that it is from this video. I hope you enjoy this video, because in this video we have talked about importing modules in a Python program, which is most important for your syllabus, for your study. Thanks for watching this video.